Today we're going to do a little bit more with LEDs and learn a little bit about breadboards.
Breadboards allow you to work on projects without having to solder, making it easy to fix mistakes before you do your final project. This smaller breadboard has rows going this way, and the way they work is that these five plugs are connected in a row, and these five, so going all the way across, we've got our rows connected. They're not connected this way. So, if we were able to take two wires, blue and green, if I was to plug one into that first one in that row, and plug another one into that one there, they are now connected. But if I was to connect down here, they are not connected, or if I was connected over here, it would not be connected because of the divider in the middle. Now, I could use a jumper and jump from here to here, and now this full top row is connected because of the jumper going from here to here. This larger breadboard works the same way. It has the rows with the divider in the middle, but it also has two columns on the side, which are connected vertically instead of horizontally. And they're usually used for your power, your positive and your negative or ground. And usually you'll connect into them from your board or a power supply, and then you would jump the negative to negative and the positive to positive. So now you would have power going down both sides of your board that you can jump to from the side into your rows like so. Here I have the basic Arduino board with the Blink application that I installed, showed you in the last tutorial, which is an example application, which is going to make LED on pin 13 blink. I'm going to be using a 9-volt battery pack to power it this time around. The board's already been programmed. I'm going to plug that in, turn on my battery pack, and you'll see once again that the LED that's built into the board is blinking. But if I take my LED once again and put the positive end, which is the longer lead, into the pin 13 and the shorter pin into the ground, I will get a blinking LED there. But if you want to have more than one LED, you can use the breadboard. So let's do that. I'm going to pull the LED out and I'm going to take two wires I've got. I've got a red and black wire, and I am going to connect the black one to ground, and I'm going to jump it over to my breadboard here. And then I'm actually going to jump it over here, further towards the middle. But it doesn't matter because it's going across the row. So this whole row right here, these four other pins, or spots for pins, are ground. If I stick this red wire into my pin 13 and jump it over here to another row, that whole row is positive. So now I can take my LED, stick it in the breadboard. Remember, the longer lead is the positive. I'm going to stick it in so it matches up with the two rows that I've set up already, and you can see I get a blinking red LED. But now I can continue to connect LEDs across that row and get myself a whole row of blinking LEDs. Did I get it in the pin there? There we go. Obviously, once you start getting a lot of LEDs, they'll start drawing more power and they may not shine as bright each, but there I have four LEDs going. Now, if I wanted more, I can unhook one of these LEDs and I can then jump the red positive over to the other side of the board here. I'll actually move it down here to give myself a little more room to work. And I'll do the same with the ground. If I can get it in there, there we go. And I'll stick it in over here. And now I have four more pins that I can do four more LEDs with. So I'll once again start here. Positive to positive and negative to negative. And that is how a breadboard works. With no soldering, so I can test out my project before I start soldering and commit to a project. So, breadboards are simple as long as you remember that you have rows, and then the larger board will have the columns if you'd like to supply power. And that's the basis of a breadboard.